Hi guys.
Myself, Pranav, is here to deliver today's presentation, Power Transformer Part 56. As the subject is of the continuation, so for your convenience, the link of the previous one is given under the description box. Let's start with auto transformer with multiple taps. Normally, multiple taps or connection points along the winding of the auto transformer are thus to impose for providing adjustable output voltages to supply power at various installations. Better voltage regulation that can therefore be made possible by adjusting these taps where any system is liable to operate more or less at constant voltage. A special purpose auto transformers are typically deployed in electrical substations where system voltage stability would have been the major criteria, and on some occasions, it is required to change voltage levels by only a small amount or a small fraction, you know. As of the figure 176, the voltage is thus to be induced across each of the tap sections will be proportionate to its number of turns. The voltage and current, which would have to develop due to the resultant effect of magnetic induction across the winding and the core, must therefore be proportionately added or subtracted across the winding, depending on the number of turns. See the diagram. Single phase auto transformer with multiple tapping points. Here, the point from A to D, that is AED, is the series section, and ABC is the common section of the winding. Application of three-phase auto transformer. In transmission power network, auto transformers are the most common as well as vital components as applied to interconnect high voltage or extra high voltage power network systems. Instead of conventional transformer, three-phase auto transformer is preferably used for transformation of polyphase voltages where the voltage ratio would never be greater than 2. Unlike conventional transformers, the winding of three-phase auto transformers are never be included, insulated electrically. Instead, the process of induction would have to occur on self-induction. Again, I repeat, unlike conventional transformers, the windings of three-phase auto transformers are never be insulated electrically. Instead, the process of induction would have to occur on self-induction. Thus, the primary and secondary sides are being connected in both electrically and magnetically, which means only part of the energy is transmitted via magnetic coupling. Such type of proposition would have to save the iron, that is ferromagnetic material, and that intends to provide a more compact design as well. See the Y-connected auto transformers. three single phase transformers connected. Type of load, such as resistive, inductive, or capacitive, which would have varying voltage configurations with different nature of load characteristics, has obviously a great intent to have the selection of auto transformer to connect. Auto transformer of three phase configurations can be made, one, by using a bank of three identical single phase auto transformer to build a single unit three phase auto transformer, that is as of figure 177. Another one, number two, three phase three limbed port type auto transformer as of figure 178. Application of star connected three phase auto transformers are being normally preferred in distribution network and in many respect that would have to behave as of YY connected conventional type of three phase auto transformers. Instead of installing single large three phase auto transformers, most of the users prefer to depend on using auto transformer banks built in three single phase units. Why connected auto transformer three phase? Such configuration that would have to ensure wide range of design flexibility at manufacturing stage, better mode of transportation from factory to site, less complexity in site installation, systematic maintenance scheduling, and cost-effective spare management. Auto transformers are widely used on radial distribution feeder circuits as voltage regulators, where the input is constant, but the output is as per requirement can be varied by varying the tappings. As the secondary is the part of the primary winding, so in case of auto transformer, the window space that would have been less as compared to conventional two winding transformer. Hence, there is some distinctive saving of material iron during the formation of core lamination part, which allows to have a more compact in designing configuration. Limitation in auto transformer connection. It is worth to note that apart from star connected configuration, no other three phase connections are being possible in case of three phase auto transformer. In practical application, the star connected configuration is of the most preferred application in three phase auto transformer. The delta connection, though it is theoretically possible, but such type of connection is not at all preferred, as because this will create a peculiar phase shift phenomenon which cannot be changed or eliminated. While installing auto transformer of Y-type configuration, it is specifically noted that both the line and load side neutral cables must be connected to the neutral terminals as provided by the original equipment manufacturer in order to ensure the proper operation of the auto transformer. Advantage of the auto transformer. One, relatively smaller in size, low cost, less weight due to less copper and iron, less voltage drop. These all are the most favorable points. Number two, as the ohmic and coil losses are being relatively less, so compared to conventional transformer, the efficiency of auto transformer is always be in higher side. Required ferromagnetic material for the formation of core would have been relatively less, so the material cost savings are therefore be appreciable for auto transformer of low transformation ratio. Less core material means lower core weight, and that leads to requirement of smaller exciting current. Most important, less core material means lower core weight, and that leads to requirement of smaller amount of exciting current. Auto transformer, as being configured with single winding, so it has the lower percentage impedance, causing better voltage regulation. Disadvantages of the auto transformer. Star connection would have been the simplest and most economical connection, whereas delta connection is rarely used as its transformation ratio is larger than that of Y connected by approximately 1.16 to 1.73 times. As being of lower series impedance, that can instigate higher short circuit currents. Number four, the system's fault current, if somehow becomes higher than the mechanical forces as developed in the auto transformer, may have a chance to exceed its withstand capability, causing a severe damage. Number five, to restrict this fault current, there would have been recommended to impose suitable current limiting reactors in series with the auto transformer. Number six, as due to have an electrical connection between the high voltage and low voltage sides, so any disturbances such as noise or voltage abnormally coming in anomaly, voltage anomaly coming in one of the sides, that also has to impose on the other. Again, I repeat, as due to have an electrical connection between the high voltage and low voltage sides, so any disturbances such as noise or voltage anomaly coming in one of the sides, that also has to impose on the other side. Number seven, it is therefore to what mentioned that whenever there is any occurrence of single line to ground fault on the high voltage side, then a voltage surge to earth will invariably be imposed on the healthy phases of low voltage side. Number eight, however, consequential effect that would have been diminished to some extent if there may have a direct grounding from neutral. Number nine, that is the reason for which auto transformer, while connected in high voltage system, then the system neutral should have to be directly grounded. Most important, being of the same quantum of voltage surge as imposed at the line terminals, then the impressed and the induced voltages would have been greater for an auto transformer rather than the conventional one. Single phase auto transformer step down configuration. As of figure 179, if there may have any occurrence of breakage in the common part of the winding, then the subject auto transformer would therefore to act as an inductor in series with the connected load at secondary. If there may have any occurrence of breakage in the common part of the winding, then the subject auto transformer would therefore to act as an inductor in series with the connected load at secondary. Under lightly loaded conditions, the secondary voltage that would have become nearly equal to the primary voltage. Number 13, such type of incidence would cause more severity as the entire primary and supply voltage may come across at the output terminal in the event of breakage in the common part of the winding. Because of a single winding configuration, the primary and secondary winding both would have to experience the same voltage stress. And that is the reason to provide an uniform insulation level for the entire winding section of an auto transformer. That is the reason to provide an uniform insulation level for the entire winding section of an auto transformer. So far the short circuit is concerned, auto transformers would have the less protective as compared to conventional transformer. Number 17, any occurrence of short circuit once it is developed in the secondary circuit, that is the common part of the winding of an auto transformer, then the insulating primary side current rather, that would have become much larger than that of the equivalent conventional transformer. Number 18, extensive flow of current in the primary side may thus to damage the auto transformer or other connected equipment. In case of auto transformer, the neutral connection is thereby common to both the primary and secondary windings. As there is no isolation between the two windings, so earthing of secondary winding is automatically made to earth the primary. And sometimes double wound transformers are thus to be installed just to isolate the equipment from the earth. Provision of tertiary winding for large size auto transformers. An auto transformer in either a single or three phase configuration is one type of power transformer that is applied to interconnect extra high voltage power network systems and is responsible for transferring large amount of energy between them. Auto transformer in its lifetime is exposed to numerous dielectric, thermal, and mechanical stresses as due to have certain incidents of overvoltage and short circuits in the power transmission network. Perhaps any single phase to ground short circuit occurs in the network with power transformers having isolated neutral points, then temporary overvoltages would thereby have to appear in the corresponding healthy phases. This phenomenon is already been discussed in the video of power transformer part 50, https://youtube.com/wifeuoqz11qz1ila. As an usual practice, auto transformer neutral is always be solidly connected to the substation earthing system. If the system with power transformer having neutral point is solidly grounded or grounded over low impedance, then no such significant overvoltages will appear on the healthy phases when connected auto transformers as of without stabilizing winding. Particularly when auto transformer is connected with the circuit of a three-phase, three-wire HV system, that is of delta configuration, and any sort of single phase to ground short circuit occurs in the network, then the subject auto transformer's zero sequence impedance that would have been severely affected, causing a flow of third harmonic current. Most important, to restrict these voltage harmonics and unbalances in the network, large capacity auto transformers are thereby typically equipped with the delta connected tertiary windings, which also acts as stabilizing winding. A buried tertiary winding is usually used to accommodate unbalanced loads, but its terminal that can also be brought out to a set of external bushings to provide external power for the station service, that is local load, station service, local load, power compensation, etc. So, rating of tertiary winding would have to depend upon its use. Basically, a tertiary winding of an auto transformer, though it is an electrically isolated auxiliary winding, but that normally has the limited power handling capability relative to the corresponding auto transformer windings. Delta connected tertiary winding, while it is required to supply an auxiliary load at different voltage level, then the selection of its winding cross section that would have been emphatically designed as corresponds to the characteristics of connected load and of three-phase dead short circuit on its terminal with power flow from both sides, that is high voltage side and medium voltage side. While it is exclusively meant for stabilizing purpose, then its winding cross-section and design concept both would have to be decided through the corresponding thermal and mechanical stresses that may have to develop for the short circuit, may have to develop for the short duration fault currents during various fault conditions in which single line to ground fault is being the most severe one. Again, I repeat, while it is exclusively meant for stabilizing purpose, that tertiary winding acts as stabilizing winding purpose. So, while it is exclusively meant for stabilizing purpose, then its winding cross section and design concept both would have to be decided through the corresponding thermal and mechanical stresses that may have to develop for the short duration fault currents during various fault conditions in which single line to ground fault is being the most severe one. Stabilizing winding is used for the purpose of stabilizing the neutral point of the fundamental frequency voltages to eliminate excessive third harmonic voltages, and at the same time, it has to provide an internally closed circuit for zero sequence current, for flow of zero sequence currents. Auto transformer tertiary winding, if not connected as a generating source, can effectively reduce the overall zero sequence impedance that has little impact on the positive and negative sequence impedance network. However, any occurrence of fault at stabilizing windings that may lead to disastrous failure of transformer itself. In the case of stabilizing winding, one of the winding terminals of its delta connection is there to be solidly grounded for the purpose of stabilizing the potential of the winding, and only two connections are then to be available from outside of the transformer tank. And one winding is solidly grounded and other two will give some power. This may have to eliminate certain possibility of fault occurrence when using stabilizing winding compared to load connected tertiary winding. Again, I repeat, in the case of stabilizing winding, one of the winding terminals of its delta connection is there to be solidly grounded for the purpose of stabilizing the potential of the winding, and only two connections are then to be available for outside of the transformer tank. This may have to eliminate certain possibility of fault occurrence when using stabilizing winding compared to load connected tertiary winding. Mainly two factors that are to be seriously dealt with during designing of stabilizing windings. One, stabilizing windings may always have to encounter significant thermal stress caused by circulating currents resulting from continuous as well as temporary load fluctuation or certain voltage unbalance on the main windings. Stabilizing windings may also have to counteract mechanical stress caused by the short circuit currents. Let's stop here. Further to be continued at later stage. Thank you for listening the video. Kindly do like, share and subscribe. Your subscription would encourage to post more videos. Also share your comments or feedbacks inside the dedicated comment section. If you have any suggestions or specific topic you want, then let me know in the comment section, please. Thank you. Thank you for patient hearing.